Hello, as in previous video, we did public key encryption, that is asymmetric key cryptography, and where we discussed symmetric and asymmetric keys and the difference between symmetric key cryptography and asymmetric key cryptography. Now, in asymmetric key cryptography, we have RSA algorithm. So, in this video, we will see what is RSA algorithm with example. So this is most widely accepted public key and RSA solved key exchange problem. Key exchange problem that we discussed before, it is faced in symmetric key cryptography, where sender and receiver were using same keys for the encryption and the decryption of the message. Now in case of RSA, we are using two keys for the encryption and decryption. So the two keys that we are using here is public key and the private key. Public key is used for the encryption and private key is used for the decryption. Public key is shared with everyone and private key is kept secret. Now RSA scheme is a cipher where plain text and ciphertext are integers. Integers are in between 0 to n minus 1 and the size of n is 1024 bits or in decimal 309 digits. So in short, value for n is less than 2 raised to power. RSA algorithm is based on the fact that it is easy to find and multiply large prime numbers together, but it is extremely difficult to factor their product. So that's just the basic concept on which RSA is based on. So RSA is based on this fact, you can easily multiply and find large prime numbers, but it is difficult to factor their products, which make RSA even more secure from the attackers. That's why this algorithm is the secure algorithm and it is hard to break for the attackers. Now, public and the private keys in RSA are based on large prime numbers. So we are using here prime numbers for the public and private keys, and the prime number can be made up of 100 or more digits. Then, as you know about prime number, that can be divided by 1 or itself. 3 is a prime number because it can be divided by only 1 and 3. 4 is not a prime number because we can divide it by 2, and prime number is divided by 1 and itself only. So example of prime number, we have 5, 7, 11, 13, 17. Non-prime numbers are 6, 8, 9 and so on. So we are using here prime numbers for the public and private keys that are based on prime numbers. Now this is the RSA algorithm. The first step is choose two large prime numbers P and Q, calculate N, that is P into Q. After that we will select public key for the encryption and we will choose public key such that it is not a factor of this. After that we will select private key for the decryption such that the following equation is true. After that, for the encryption of the message, we will use this encryption algorithm where we will compute the ciphertext, that is plain text raised to power e. Here we are applying public key, that is for the encryption, mod of n. After that, we will send the cipher to receiver. Now receiver want to read the message, so now we will convert this ciphertext into plain text. So now we will compute the plain text from cipher that can be computed using this decryption algorithm. For example, I'm taking two prime numbers P and Q, that is P is 7, Q is 17. Step 2 is compute N is P into Q. So 7 into 17 is 119. Value for N is this. Step 3 is we will select the public key for encryption. So how we will select the public key? Using this equation, put the value of P, that is 7, value of Q is 17, and we got 96. Next step is we will find the factor for 96, and we will got this one. After this, we will select the public key such that it is not factor of this, that is, we will choose public key such that it is not factor of 96, that is, none of factor of E is 2 and 3. So we cannot choose 4, 6, 15 because they contain 2 and 3 in factors. Suppose E is 5, and for 5 we have factor 1 and 5. So we will select the value for E is 5, and it satisfies this condition. Next step is select the private key that is used for the decryption such that it also satisfies this condition. Put the value for D, E, P, Q. We don't know right now the value for D, so put the value for E, that is 5. Value for P is 7, Q is 17. Then you will got this. Suppose value for D is 77. Put the value of D here. After that, you will got 385 mod 96, that is equal to 1. Here, condition is satisfied. So you will select private key, that is D. You will choose, you will put all the values until this condition is true. So we did 77. So now condition is satisfied. Now we will use value for D is 77. So these are the challenges faced in RSA is the selection and the generation of the public and private key. You can see it is extremely difficult here in this case to choose this value. That's why this algorithm is much secure. Challenge in RSA is the selection of public and private key. Now we will compute the ciphertext from the plain text. That is, now we will apply encryption algorithm using this. So we can compute the ciphertext by this, put the value here. So suppose we have plain text, that is 10. Again, I'm saying RSA scheme is a cipher where plain text and the ciphertext are integers. So suppose we have plain text 10 that we want to send to another user. Now we will apply encryption algorithm on this plain text. So ciphertext is plain text mod of n. So you will got the value for ciphertext is 40. After that, send the cipher to receiver. Now receiver want to read the message, so for this we will apply decryption algorithm on the ciphertext. So we will compute now plain text, and the value for ciphertext is 40. Put the value here, and we got 10. That is the plain text message sent by sender. Security of RSA. Yet no successful attack on RSA have been reported. You can see this is extremely difficult to compute all this. We cannot select easily public and private keys even. So the selection of public and private keys, here you can see it is difficult task. So it is difficult to crack this algorithm for the attackers. So yet no successful attack on RSA have been reported. So we have possible approaches to attack RSA, like timing attack. Timing attack is depend on the running time of the decryption algorithm. Then we have brute force attack, where attacker can try all the possible private keys, and we can have hardware fault based attack and choose ciphertext attack. So this is RSA algorithm for the encryption. So this is most secure and widely used. So these are the basic steps that you can follow in RSA algorithm. Choose two prime numbers, compute and select public and private keys, then use encryption and decryption algorithm. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching.